In this video, we're going to show you how powerful user-defined components can truly be. Here, we're going to drag and drop a shaft bearing component and position it on our assembly. As you can see, you can change its position at any time. Next, we're going to have it optimize the bearing based on the diameter of that shaft. And we'll validate. From there, we're going to show you another way to position a copy of that component. First, we'll close our project tree, and then holding Control on our keyboard, we'll grab the component and drag and drop it to make a copy. Like that, it's positioned. We'll change its angle to 90 degrees. From here, we'll optimize the shaft diameter again. And then, we're going to decide to fasten this using nuts as well. But in order to get the good length of the bolt, we're going to take an associative measurement for the thickness of our plate. And like that, our bolts are now set at the right length. From here, we're going to hide the two bearings just to show you that the correct drillings were put in. On the left, a drilled and tapped hole, and on the right, a clearance hole. Next, we're going to change the thickness of the plate and show you how intelligent these components truly are. Like that, it's 10 millimeters thicker. And if we look, our bolts are now longer, as well as the nuts are in the correct place. In this next sample, we're going to create a weld fixture using a user-defined component. All we do is select the two key points we want to use to position it, and TopSolid 7 does the rest of the work for us, including positioning the part. Let's do that again. Select our two points, validate, and we're done. Let's add one more support. Here we'll select point 1 and point 2, and like that, our third weld fixture has been added. Next, if we flip this over, you'll see that it even included the correct machining for our screws. And now let's see what happens if we make a design change. As you'll see, everything automatically updates thanks to the power of TopSolid 7.